Hi, it's Michael from the Red Shirt Diaries. I've done videos on this topic that I just don't cotton to the gay pride parades, and I never wanted them to stop, you know, like, but I get haters coming after me that, you know, as if I'm telling them that I think that they should stop everything they're doing. I'm saying I don't understand the excitement over the hoopla, and also not to forget that a lot of the people in that audience hate you, and that a lot of them are just mouthing, they may not, and the other ones may not hate you, but they wouldn't want your son to marry one of you. You see, that sort of thing. It's easy to have the yuppies out with their kids in strollers watching these ridiculous people, or these people in ridiculous costumes like the big feather boas and all that stuff, and the dykes on bikes and the asses hanging out of the leather chaps and all this. I think it's a circus, and a very badly thought out one, and a very badly produced one. But that's the point of freedom of choice. The people there are enjoying themselves immensely. I choose not to partake in that, and I enjoy myself not being there. So there is room for both of us in this homosexual universe of ours. But I wish I could stop hearing that expression, the gay community. I've been in the gay community since 1974, and I've never felt like I was in the gay community. But I've been out there supporting gay rights. I've been out at work ever since 1974. I've stood up for myself. I've stood up for homosexuals. I've stood up for lots of different things. And I always say that I never left the Catholic Church. It left me. So there are different ways of getting points across. But I've lived my life with dignity every time, every day, whatever, that I could. And by dignity, I mean standing up for myself and not being a second-class citizen. So that, to me, is my version of gay pride. And if you're just going to send me a note and tell me to fuck off, just fuck yourself, because I'm not interested, okay? I've been down this road. I have been out there being part of gay liberation for a long time, and it had nothing to do with wearing a dress, wearing butterfly wings, wearing 6-inch eyelashes and high heels, or walking on stilts, okay? So, you know, you people get your shit together. Now, another part of this, of course, is that, yes, drag queens do a lot of fundraising and good for the community, and I've never said they haven't. So you don't have to give me the rant about that. I'm just agreeing with explorationB and Tori Amos. That's all. Many of you disagree with me, but there is actually possibly a silent majority that agrees with me. Okay? Anyway, Michael from the Red Shirt Diaries. I'm in Bedford, Nova Scotia, and I'm not afraid to take it on. If you want to come and visit, contact me, okay? Bye-bye.